Hey y'all, it's me, Alex. Today I have a little like full face of old favorites-ish type get ready with me. If you can't guess what's on my eyes right now, I'm using the Jackie Aina palette because that is honestly one of my favorite palettes of all time. Just like the best color story, you know? So we're gonna do that. It's just kind of chill, literally just getting ready to go to the doctor today. So that's what we're doing. Just wanted to film my makeup. Thought it would be a nice and fun time for all of us. So without further ado, let's get into it. Okay, so my brows are already done as always, and I put on some lip balm because I think today might be a liquid lipstick day. Not that it matters that much, because all I'm doing today is like going to the doctor, and then like no one else is gonna, like they don't need to see my mouth for that. I'm gonna be wearing a mask that be nice, kind of match my shirt a little bit, but I don't need anyone to see my lipstick, but y'all will. So anyway, I'm gonna prime my eyes with my NYX HC eyeshadow primer as always, because this is the greatest to ever exist. And I'll say that every single get ready with me video ever, I look good. Cool. The palette that I want to use today, I was stuck between two, but I feel like this one would go better with my outfit, and then I can do another kind of shop my stash video with the other one. The Jackie Aina palette. I love this palette so much, and I haven't used it in forever, but as you can see, it's gotten like a lot of use out of it already because, hi, this is one of the most perfect color stories to literally ever exist. So the other one I was considering was the Melt Morphe palette because I also love that one and I can never get over that color story. So I think that that'll be my next up in a Shop My Stash sort of video because I love it. But this one would go better with like the color scheme of the shirt that I'm wearing today, I think, rather than like the reds and blues of that one. So I'm thinking of doing like some of the pinky shades in my crease and then like that greeny gold in there all over my lid perhaps, or ooh, halo eye, doing that. So I'm gonna begin with Supreme here, and I'm just using that on my Elf and J Kissa GA3, and I'm going to begin that in my crease as a nice little transition. It's a transition shade. Honestly, I should really just do like a beauty guru like musical, and I can take songs from other musicals like Tradition from Fiddler on the Roof, but it'll be about like transition shades and it'll be like transition, you know. I think that'll be fantastic.
Other highlights of this musical would include a version of My Favorite Things from The Sound of Music to represent a monthly favorites video, and a version of the Cell Block Tango from Chicago called The Dramageddon Tango, where each beauty guru describes how their past scandals were totally justified.
So, how have y'all been? I feel like I've done a chatty get ready with me recently, but also I feel like I haven't at the same time. Don't know what to do. I know I did a haul tutorial recently that I actually really loved how that look turned out. I think that was a super fun time. I'm kind of blending this into the inner and outer corner as well, just to kind of lay down a bit of a transition, but that's not going to be the main color that we get into both of those areas, if y'all know what I mean. I'm filming this on a Monday. I'm going to try and get it up like the same day because I was totally going to film over the weekend and then I just like got tired and I didn't. So, but it'll either be up Monday or Tuesday of this week. So now I'm going to take this brush from the Melton Beetlejuice collection. That's a little dirty right now, but I'm gonna use Pinker right there, not to flip y'all off, but I'm gonna use that on the inner and outer corner to like deepen it up and kind of begin, just kind of deepen that up and begin where I want the sort of halo effect to go. I feel like the shades in this palette blend so well together. So right now our hot water heater is broken, but I did shower this morning in like freezing cold water because my hair is looking crusty and because I do have to go out to my doctor and I want it to be like fresh and nice for that. Cold showers just make my muscles like contract in on themselves. So fortunately, I'm going to see my pain management doctor today so I can be like, hey, so can you give me like an extra something right now because we don't have hot water and while I can still be clean. I love me a hot shower and that is like a necessity in my life, but I'm getting like my trigger point injections done today finally because due to like insurance and scheduling issues, it's taking me like an extra 2 weeks to be able to get done what I need to do. So now I'm just going to use my finger actually and just take Dwala's on the center of my lip because I haven't been able to find my good e.l.f. glitter glue anywhere and I'm like out. So instead I'm just going to put that in the center. And I feel like that's going to, you know, work really well with the color scheme of my shirt, because I'm just gonna wear that with some like skinny jeans and not the pajama pants I'm currently rocking with it right now. Honestly, I think soon it might be time for me to do like a little spring fashion video, and I'm gonna take a little bit more pinker to blend that out. But I think it might be time for me to do like a little spring fashion video. As things are like kind of opening up, I'm like, oh my god, I'm gonna be perceived below my neck by people not at the grocery store soon. You know, like it's about to be that time. I feel like I need to step up my outfit game, and we're all gonna emerge from quarantine however the hell we want to. Like, there's no shame in whatever. But I am kind of having that minor freak out of like, oh, I need to look good like beyond this point, beyond my shoulders soon. So yeah. Okay, so then I'm gonna take the Elfin J Kiss the J2 and take a little bit more of Supreme and kind of do what I did in my crease along my lower lash line. I adore this color story so much. It is so pretty. Jackie Aina is one of the few YouTubers who like I started off watching when I started getting into beauty YouTube, who I still absolutely watch today. Like, I feel like she's one of the few people who I still learn things from, because there aren't a lot of people like that, I think, on beauty YouTube nowadays, because like, I don't know, either people have done something shitty or their content hasn't changed in a way to work with like the times and still teach new things. So I think she's like the one person who has. So I'm gonna take a little bit more pinker and put that a bit closer to the lash line. I kind of want to use one of my melt liners. On another hand, I don't know if those would be like too deep for what I'm going for. Yeah, I think those would be too deep, because I want something like slightly darker than pinker, but not anything like so dark that it would create a harsh line. So I think I'm just gonna leave it like this as far as like my waterline goes. Let's see, where's my little inner corner brush that I love so very much? I think I'm going to take Trust Issues and pop that on the inner corner, because that has like, it's white but with like a nice little greeny shift, so that'll still kind of bring out the green, the yellowy green in Dwellas. Yeah, this is just so pretty. I love this little palette. The last good thing Anastasia did. This was the last good palette they made, and then they did everything wrong. RIP them. Okay, so I'm gonna curl my lashes. I love this lash curler so much. I guess I think I need to film an anti-haul soon, because I realized like last year I did an anti-haul of like things I actually wanted like every single month, and then I haven't done any like at all in 2021. I still like talk myself out of stuff. I'm using my Perversion mascara from Urban Decay. So like I still talk myself out of stuff, because I think that was like genuinely good practice for me last year. Like I think I smudged the hell out of my mascara. But I think that that was good practice and has created like good budgeting stuff for me, you know? But I do want to like do that publicly again, because I also think that y'all enjoy that kind of stuff too, because I think if you're here watching my videos, you probably have the same taste in makeup as me, so you probably go after similar things or even put similar things on your wish list. So you might need to be talked out of the same things that I do. Okay, eyes are done. This looks really cute. Okay, now let's go into the one base product that I ever use, because I don't change it that much. To NYX, bear with me, Tinted Skin Veil. And I'm still squeezing the water out of my sponge, because I tried to go in and do like an extra big wash on it this morning, but that means that there's still like extra water in there. Like, I don't know if that's a common experience, but like not being able to entirely get all of the water out of your makeup sponge is like a thing that like I hate. So I just start that at like the center of my face and work it out, because I feel like that's the best way to blend it in a way that looks like natural. And I also know like the center of my face with like my red cheeks is kind of where the majority of like the coverage that I need needs to happen, you know? Okay, cool. That's done. Okay, so I was gonna go back and use like, you know, for the sake of this video, it's like old favorites, woo. But honestly, ever since I got the Noon palette from Midas, I simply do not feel like I can use any other like contour, bronzer or anything like that on my face. It just doesn't make sense, because this is such a good little formula. So I'm gonna use that. And I'm not gonna have any shame about it, even though it's a relatively new favorite of mine. So I'm just going to take the contour shade on the Real Techniques Expert face brush and contour my cheekbones. I still need to film my Genesis 3 Looks 1 palette. Those take a lot of effort for me to be able to film, and I want to be able to put in that effort, but like depression and like tiredness and pain is like a thing that I've genuinely really been going through recently, and I want to be able to do it right, but I also feel like every time that I have the like free time to be able to put into a 3 looks on palette video, I don't have the energy. Like my time and my energy don't line up, you know what I mean? So it's either like y'all will get a really rushed one or like just a really like depressed one, and I don't think either of them, that doesn't feel right to me. So I'm gonna use the bronzer very, very lightly to blend this out. So yeah, that's why y'all haven't gotten that from me yet. I just wanna be able to feel right when I do stuff like that. Okay, cool. So that part, like the contour and the bronzer part, is done. So I want to go in with a cream blush before I do my like highlight and powder blush. So I'm gonna use this ColourPop blush sticks in 25-8, which I feel like is a really nice color. I don't know why I feel the need to make that noise when I do it, but we're here. We're queer. We're filled with existential fear. And I kind of like try and push it up, that way my cheekbones are like more prominent, you know what I mean? And it's not like dragging down my face. And I just like, if I have any left, I tap it on the end of my nose. So now I'm going to go back into the Noon palette and just use that little highlighter on a Real Techniques setting brush. When I talk like that, I feel like Alicia from Kinky Sweat, but with like a lot fancier, like her brushes are a lot fancier than mine. And then to kind of blend it all together, I'm gonna use a blush from this palette, which looks really pink in there, but when I actually like apply it to my face, I feel like it's a really nice tone that just like looks like a natural flush on me. So I think maybe I do need to lean a little bit more into pink blushes that I wouldn't normally go for. If this looks like this good on my face, maybe I don't need to be as afraid of it as I am. I want to use an old favorite lipstick of mine, and that is the Fluid Beauty Liquid Lipstick in Candy Bar. I love this shade so much. This is one of my favorite neutral lipsticks. Also, I'm like fiddling with my hair a lot because I feel like ever since I got it cut, it looked really nice at the salon and like the first 2 days I got it cut, but then I haven't been able to style it correctly ever since. So I'm gonna put on the lipstick. I hate that I can never get the bow of my lips right, but this is a really good color. I feel like this shade sort of universally goes with the Jackie Aina palette, you know what I mean? I feel like this is pretty cute. So let me spray my face since I am gonna move. You know when like your brain gets ahead of like how quickly you can talk or vice versa? That happens to me a lot. But I'm gonna use my all-nighter setting spray since I am gonna wear a mask. So I wanna make sure that this like actually stays on just in case I so happen to have enough energy to film another video once I get home tonight. So that is this look. I like how it turned out. I mean, I always do. I've never had a look with the Jackie Aina palette that I didn't like how it turned out. It's just a simple fact. It is that good. Okay, so that's it. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know how you're doing down below. The world is weird. It always is. But it gets weirder and weirder by the day, my friends. So let me know how you're doing. Thank you so much for watching. Give it a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe if you want to see more videos from me. And I will see y'all in my next video. I hope y'all have a wonderful day. Bye.